Hello, welcome to my Minecraft tutorial. This is episode number 67 in my How to Survive and Thrive series. And in today's episode, we are going to craft up some item frames and flower pots. Yes, indeed. It's like arts and craft day today, Tang, so I hope you brought your apron and maybe an X-Acto knife, because we are going to be cutting up some leather and some sticks and getting all messy with clay balls. What do you think about that? Okay, so, I know this doesn't really have much to do with survival, but hey, what's the point of toiling and laboring in this dangerous frontier world if we can't actually sit back and enjoy the little things? Mm-hmm. Just nod with me. There we go. Now, you may recall in the last episode when I made this the anvil in the forge, I threw up these, well, I didn't throw them up, but I built them and I placed them, these item frames, and I put armor and a sword inside, and I said, you know what, let's do that in the next episode. So that's why we're doing that now, and then we'll get back to the adventure and survival stuff in the next episode, most likely. But let's have a little fun here. These are very fun. So this is an item frame right here, and I'm going to show you how to craft these in a minute, but once you place an item frame, you can get it back simply by hitting it with your hand and climbing the roof, because I think that chest plate is stuck up top. Oh, there it is. You can always rely on Minecraft to make it look like a fool. So now here's my item frame, not to be confused with picture frame, and I will most certainly call this picture frame 6 or 7 times throughout this tutorial, I guarantee it. Now, to place an item frame, you just right click and there it is. It's empty, and you can put just about anything in there, and you can get the item back as I just demonstrated. So you don't lose that item. It just represents the item in the picture. It's or object frame rather. And again, you can simply get it back by punching it, and it'll fall from the sky and potentially get stuck on a roof. That is the item frame and basically how it works. So we're going to go ahead and run around to all of my various locations here in my settlement, and we're going to do some decorating. But before we do that, we need to get some clay balls, because we need clay bricks to make some clay to make the flower pots. So it's like, it's pottery class, people. Now, this is the coolest art class you've ever been in, because how many times have your teachers ever told you to go jump in a river to collect clay balls? Probably not too many times. And if they did, they would most likely get their heads examined, or the parents would be up in arms, or whomever else. I think 24 clay balls ought to be enough. By the way, you can download this map just as you see it here with everything that I have in my inventory, so you don't have to do much work, because we are going to utilize all of these things in this episode of decor. And the link is down below in the description. You can download that and pick up right where I began, and you can follow along. Hello! There's a cow somewhere in my basement. That's pretty cool stuff. Oh dear me, here comes the rain. I don't like the rain at all. It's way too loud. All right, well, let's do this. Let's get the clay cooking up. We're gonna make some bricks. I'm going to show you how to make, hey, my steaks are done. Oh, nice. I just wonder what happened to my steaks. I had to kill a lot of cows to get this leather. And instead of screeching at you, how about if we turn the rain down? So I did have to kill a bunch of cows to get leather, because we need the leather in the recipe of an item frame. And we're going to do that in a second. Oh, boy. All right, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to wait for my bricks to cook up. And I'm going to wait for the rain to go away, and I'll be right back, because I just don't like talking over the rain. Hey, how's the rain? Looks wet. I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. I just had lunch in real life. The rain has stopped. I've got all 24 bricks all cooked up, and we're ready to continue with this project. So let's start with the flower pot. We're going to take our clay bricks, and we're going to make... Let's just make a few. So basically, it's just three bricks arranged like so. Oops, not you. And there's your flower pot. I'm going to make up 5. And this right here is the old school style flower pot. Back before 1.4 and the new flower pot, we just used to drop a block of dirt in a corner somewhere out of the way, and then surround it with trap doors to make it look like something that you spent some time crafting. We no longer have to live that way. So just go ahead and take your dirt, and if you have one of those, I did make that in a prior episode, didn't I? And just put your flower pot down, and note that it's circular in your inventory and in your hand, but when you plop it down, it changes shape. And we're going to put that rose back in there, like my cozy cottage rose. And there you go. And now to get that back, if you so desire, just give it a punch. You do get your flower pot back, as well as the item you planted in it. You can put in flower pots just about any sapling, fern, I think lily pad, flowers, and mushrooms. And we're going to do a couple of those later. We're going to head over to a cozy cabin and spruce that up a little bit. But there it is. And anything you put in here, for example, if I do put a sapling in there, it will not grow. So it doesn't, it does not mature. Okay. With that done, let's move on to the item frame. So I'm going to make a picture because I want to hang a nice picture here at Cozy Cottage. And I want to use a map. So there's actually a new map style for 1.4 as well. And I'm going to show you how that works, but we'll do a full episode on that because it's changed a lot. But for now, I'm just going to go ahead and make a new map with 1.4. And there it is. And as you can see here, in the old style map, as soon as you put it in your hand, it would start populating with the area around you. It doesn't do that anymore. You can actually right-click, and then it populates. It goes into your hand like so. And now it fills up with the surrounding area. And this is an 8x8 chunk area. So no matter where I stand in this, it's going to show this particular 8x8 chunk. And as you can see here, it's zoomed in more than the old maps. And again, I'll do a full map tutorial very soon. But this shows all the structures, which is really cool. This is what I wanted to get up on the wall with an item frame. So you can see Cozy Cottage there. I'm standing in it. The doghouse is behind me. We've got Tower of Power over there. We've got the big mushrooms over there. So that's pretty cool. Now, I thought it would be appropriate to put... What the heck? That was a cat unison screech. I thought it would be kind of neat to put this in an item frame, which you can do. So to make an item frame, it's just sticks arranged all around on the sides and a piece of leather in the center. And there's your item frame. And item frames, as with pictures, you just right-click them on the wall. There you go. And you can drop anything in there. And I'm going to put my map in. So, boom. And we get in nice and close. Here's Cozy Cottage. The green dot, that shows up on any maps that you put in frames, which is pretty cool. So you can actually go out into another chunk. Let's say I ran off this chunk over beyond Tower of Power, and I made a new map, right? Or maybe this side, either way, or this side. And then, so I made a new map. I populated it. I can make a huge wall mural with all those maps around the edges. So this is like 8x8 chunk on this side, the 8x8 over here, the 8x8 down here. So you can have a gigantic wall map. That would be pretty cool stuff. I might do that in the future somewhere. So that's item frame. And again, you hit it, you get it back. Whoa, man, they really fly, don't they, when you hit that sucker? Okay. So I think Cozy Cottage has enough decoration for now. Why don't we, whoa, that was loud. Let's head over to, I want to go over to, let's just get rid of some of this stuff. Well, I want to go visit some of the other locations that I've been around, and I'd like to spruce them all up. I'm going to start with Hidey Hole. Hidey Hole needs a little decoration, and this is just kind of a fun thing to do. It's obviously not necessary for your survival. But what the heck? I mean, we spend all this time risking our necks. It's good to have some fun, too. And this is kind of fun. All right, let's see what we have in storage. Oh, my gosh. It's my very first wooden pickaxe. Oh, no, really. It's the first one ever. And I need to make up some more item frames. I think it is anyway. I don't know. I'm being a little melodramatic, but it could be, or maybe it isn't. I don't really know. I'm going to grab, let's just make a bunch of these while we're here at a workbench. AKA crafting table. 6 ought to do. Come on, Scratchy. And I'm going to put it right above the door. Good old hidey hole. This is where it all began, folks, right here. This series, anyway. And we'll put a torch right there. My first pick in Tutorial World 2. It's now like Tutorial World 4 or something like that. Scratchy, come on. Oh, there we are. Now let's head over to the farm area, and I think we'll put up another frame. Let's go over here. Whoa, Leaping lizards. Leaping kitties, more like it. How about if we put an item frame here? Yeah, let's let's grab some of these. Easy for me to say. Grab some cocoa beans, and we're going to put a item frame right here. You can put it right on the side of the slab, and boom! Look at that. We don't even need words anymore. Who needs words? This is the old days. Before people could actually read, or a lot of people in cities could read, you would see shops with pictures of what the shop actually did. Craftsmen, like armorers and cobblers and stuff like that. Whoa, nice zip there. Scratchy's got a little zip in his stride today. All right, so now let's put one here at the old farm. And here's Spider. Let's go see. Well, let's put the item frame up first. And let's go rummage through the old box to see what we can put up. Oh, it's my very first stone hoe. No, really? No, I have no idea, but it sounded good. Oh, wait, let's put wheat. What do you think, a wheat? How about wheat? Oh, you know what? Wheat looks better, because I don't think that's my first hoe. He lied. He lied to me. Bad hoe. I think wheat looks kind of cool. Let's spin it around. Ew. Yeah, like that. There we go. That is lovely, don't you say? Wouldn't you say? You do, of course you say. All right, let's... Oh, my God, let me make a quick collection here. Look at you guys and your eggs. Come on. There we go. Get that new sound. Okay, now let's race up to the Tower of Power. And I'd like to put a couple of item frames up there. I'm going to use it for a different kind of use, not just aesthetics and for looking snazzy. But this is going to be a rather a useful purpose to these item frames. Now, I know a lot of people have storage chambers, like massive storage chambers, where there's like one gigantic room with chests all around it, and they use signs to remind them what's in them. Well, you can use picture frame, item frames too, so that's what we're going to do here. I'm going to put one there, and I'm going to put one there, and obviously I don't need this because I know what's in here, but just giving you some ideas, and I'll put an ingredient over here. That's netherwort. Kind of looks like cherries or grapes, but it's netherwort. And over here, I will put... let's put a speed potion in here. There we go. So over here I have potions, over here I have ingredients. Pretty cool stuff, eh? Pretty clever. Yeah, it would most likely be a heck of a lot more useful in storage chambers when you have, like, dozens of chests. It's not really all that... fabulous for me because I have random chests scattered around, so it's not quite as profound as it were. But there we go. Okay, let's Scratchy, come here. I know you have some zip in your stride, but I bet you can't beat me to cozy cabin. Oh, I must eat a tater. I will not race you on an empty stomach. Let's go. Watch out for the lava, please. Okay, to cozy cabin. Meet you there. I win! Ha ha! Okay, here we are. Cozy cabin. I have made a few minor changes here. You want to come in, Kitty? Come on. It's dangerous out there. No, he's fine. So I've added a little bit of, some furniture, essentially. I put my, this is the dining room table, and I put, like, this little bar here. I thought that was kind of cool. Just upside down sandstone stairs. Kind of neat, I suppose. But that's neither here nor there. What we're here to do is put up some picture frames and some flower pots. So I've already got some things in mind. Why don't we start in the kitchen? And I think what we're going to do is just... this is the best art class ever. Is put an item frame here. I said picture frame, didn't I? I meant item frame. And I'm going to put a slice of watermelon in there. Look how easy that is. My gosh, Picasso is probably rolling in his grave right now. No effort. And over here, we're gonna put something a little bit less healthy. There we go, a nice cake. And I think Let's put a flower pot here on the table, and I've got a nice yellow little flower for there. Bing. I'm gonna put a torch over here. We need some lighting because I gotta take these lights down. I'm gonna have to come up with some other solution. I was thinking glowstone blocks in the floor, maybe under the table. That should give us some glow. Scratchy, stay out of the river, please. Okay. And over here, this is a rustic home. So this is my kind of my getaway, right? My recreational getaway spot where I come and fish and hang out by the fire that I don't have. So I'm just going to put a fishing pole there. And how about a fish here? This is the lunker I caught that day. Remember that day? You know, the day that I caught the lunker, right? And so let's put flower pot here. Not sure I like that. I might swap that out later, but I've got two lovely little friends here from the old days. We've got Sappy, the original Oakland oak sapling, and Vern the fern. Welcome home, little fellas. Now, again, they will not grow. The saplings do not grow in flower pots. They shall not mature there, so you don't have to worry about that. That's excellent. And what else do we have? Oh, yeah, I wanted to put this over here. Now, some people sleep with guns under their pillows or knives or maybe a baseball bat somewhere nearby so that when the zombie apocalypse happens, they'll be ready. And they just have to reach down and grab it and fight back the hordes, right? Well, I'm one of those kinds of people. Doomsday prepper, as they call it. Except there are no baseball bats in Minecraft, so I'm going to put my Sword of Smite 2. Perfect for the zombie apocalypse. So if I were, you know, happen to be sleeping and all of a sudden, I could just go, bang! Yeah! Oh, wait, yeah! Okay, silly stuff, but hey, why not, right? I'm a silly guy. Okay, let's put a mushroom here, too, in case I get a midnight snack. Feeling of a midnight snack, anyway. And there we go! I think that about covers it. I feel this is so much more homey now, don't you think? I think so. So, all right. Well, I guess that's it. Let's see what Scratch is up to. Scratchy, what are you doing down here? Oh my gosh, you're digging up the dirt. Why are you doing it? Okay. Trying to get something? There's really nothing in there for you. Come on inside where it's safe, where we can say goodbye and move on to the next episode. Get ready for the next episode. So that's pretty much it. Frames, picture frames, and flower pots. And that is the end of art class. Art 101. Arts and crafts 101, that is. And then I think in the next episode, we'll head out and find us a witch. We're going to go to a swamp and see if we can find a witch hut. I hope you all enjoyed. And if you did, a thumbs up is always appreciated, which helps my channel. And it'll give you a nice warm, fuzzy feeling. I think. Or if not, well, then you don't have to. But anyway, I'll see you all next time. Have a good day. Bye-bye. Oh, wait a minute. I'm back. Yeah, I have a difficult time saying goodbye. And I'm forgetful. I wanted to show you that you could take a cactus and put it in a flower pot. There you go. So, in fact, this is not a flower pot. It's a cacti pot. And they don't hurt either. Look at that. The little mini guys. They're awesome. In fact, the cats and the dogs are going to love that because they're constantly bumping into them. All right. Anyway, that's it. So class is dismissed. Art class is dismissed, that is. You are free to go. Goodbye.